Against the spectacular backdrop of the Singapore skyline, Formula One returns once again to do battle in what tends to become something of an endurance race, with the notorious sauna-like temperatures in the cockpit making for an extremely physically challenging Grand Prix. We're here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit today, located in the heart of Singapore. The circuit consists of 23 corners, 13 to the left and 10 to the right. It's a track that's incredibly technical, so don't expect to see the drivers taking too much at full throttle. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Joker lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Hamilton, Daniel Ricciardo and Leclerc, Norris, Sainz, Vettel and Yuki Tsunoda, Stroll, Russell, Esteban Ocon and Perez, Gasly, Latifi, Antonio Giovinazzi and Mick Schumacher, Aylett and Nikita Mazepin. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
We're still second to Bottas, but you're in a position to claim the driver's championship, so give it your best shot. Tire condition is still looking good. Okay, some information on Bottas. They seem to have an issue. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. A new strategy. No need to worry about tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. Be careful with the front wing. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Box, box. We're coming in this lap. Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now. Release, release. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tyres. Valtteri is in the pits. Tire condition is still looking good. No need to worry about tire condition for now. Everything's looking good. Okay, focus. We need to stay on form. No issues with tire wear for now. Keep taking care of them. We think we may see some rain. ETA is about 15 minutes. We're leading our teammate by 12.0 seconds. This pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Moved into P4, 4th place now. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Mind that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage. No tyre concerns at the moment. Just focus on the driving. Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Currently, the fastest lap is a 1:37.9. Radar suggests some weather is going to hit in around 5 minutes' time, so stay on your toes. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. Top job, my friend, top job. I was a bit worried about this one at the start of the weekend, but you've pulled through. Thank you.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Joker takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Well, there was a lot of incredible driving out there today, Crofty, but if I had to pick someone, it's got to be Sergio Perez. Fantastic driving.
And it's another title in the bag for Red Bull. After a long and hard-fought season, they've built an astonishing car this year, and the glory they'll be taking back to Milton Keynes is fully deserved. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. And with that, we wrap up another weekend of motorsport. But with more races lined up, be sure to join us when we come back with more Formula One.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. Would you say this is not quite the result you wanted after how well you performed here last year?
You scraped the walls a few times. Were you struggling for grip?
Thank you for your time.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.